This video is going to show you how to generally recover a project, even if it doesn't go, even if you can only recover some items, you can still do something about it. The thing that was causing the problem on my project was essentially Reflex Nexus. I know that some of you out there will say, stay away from it. But anyway, it doesn't really matter. But that's really the problem. And of course, I don't really have Nexus anymore. So the dongle isn't plugged in, ergo, everything falls apart. So this is basically what I do. So here, I know that the project tempo was 130. So I save the set in a new folder, and I'm going to call this project recovery because I've already made it. Recover me. So here is the actual project itself. As you can see, it's from quite a while ago. So in this Recover Me project, what you need to do is to bring your project in the same level as your set. You should be able to open this up, have a look under Current Projects, and as you can see, when we open this file up here, you can see all of the MIDI tracks or audio tracks or whatever they might be. The only things we're not sort of recovering here in this lot here are the returns and anything that's on the master channel. That's kind of it. I've already been through this, so you know, I'm just going to let you know. And the two tracks that will cause the crashes are here, bell and low synth. Because I know the bell and the low synth are going to cause problems. Plus, I know that I've got contact libraries. Plus, I also know that I've moved my hard drives around since then. This is going to be a sort of like one channel at a time. But sometimes this is kind of what you, this is sort of what you need to do to be able to work out where the problems are. After this, we need to click here. We get a list of all of the files that are missing. Really important thing is to look down here, which tells you the location. So this one is WA production, EDM, loops, claps, and so on. So I'm going to find all of these samples using the browser. The thing about the browser is that you can just type in the name. Wow. So if I take that, Ableton will actually scan that folder to find out if any of the missing samples are in that folder. Fantastic. As you can see, it's found quite a few more. So we're missing two, FX and claps. Found everything. Save it. So now that we've done that, I'm just going to do a quick run through on the track. Ableton Live, and for some reason you can't open up a project, this is one method that you can use to recover, if not all of it, then most of it. Until next time.